Hello, it's Jang here with a look at LEGO Bionicle's Akida, Creature of Water. So there it is completed, and it does come with a shadow trap, which is much larger than the rest. We'll have to look at this in just a minute. Obviously, Akida, creature of water, is a water creature, somewhat fish-like in its inspiration with its fins and such. Here's a question. How many times have you heard me say in LEGO reviews, stand not included? If you want to pose this, you need to create your own stand. You need to add your own parts. I added my own parts, those are not included. Well, you're not gonna hear me say any of that in this review because this actually comes with the stand. What do you know about that? It's just three pieces, but it's so nice that they actually included it and it works quite well. It doesn't really attach, it just sets into place, kind of balances, but allows you to pose it up like that. Look at that, it spins around nicely. That's a really, really nice touch. I really appreciate that. Makes it easier for me to actually display this as well. As you can see, we've got a ball joint, or a single ball bone piece right here, which is going to allow you to articulate the tail somewhat. You can bring that up, you can also bring this down, and you can go side to side with it. So you can get lots of nice, realistic, organic kind of posing out of this. You can also change the angles of these fins here. Bring them down, bring them up. You can bring these shooter pods up. You can actually bring them closer together like so. That's an interesting look in and of itself. I might even like that look better than the default, just how it kind of compacts and packages everything together there. Almost looks more aggressive that way to me. And maybe there's a way to angle the head to get that in there a little bit closer. Yeah, I like that actually. I really like what they've done with these shooters because they use the transparent light blue ones so you can see all the way through, and they use propellers on the back. And those are used to actually turn the axles, which turn the trigger mechanism. So if you turn the propeller yourself, that's going to shoot off studs. Uh-oh, this one's a little bit stiff here. There we go. There we go. Now it's going. Those studs are going to go everywhere. I'm not going to do any more. But that's actually how you shoot this, is by turning these. Once you have no studs in there, then you can just spin them freely. But you can kind of imagine that to be an additional kind of add-on propulsion unit as well. And I appreciate the pieces they kind of used for shoulders here, just bringing in a little bit more of that trans light blue. And there's a little bit more trans light blue also inside with the thin Technic lift arms, the extra thin, half thickness ones. Just nice pieces to get. Yeah. The color scheme on this whole thing, oh yeah, Borok eyes in orange, also nice. These are nice to get in orange, kind of flame type pieces. I think the colors work on this in general. It actually looks like you've got trans light blue in the center section of the head here, but that's just a little bit of mix between silver and the trans dark blue. So it's actually only two colors that are used for that head, the trans dark blue and the silver. And they chose a good point at which to initiate the blend, and just how far the blend goes is also a good thing, I'd say. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with this whole thing, both for display and for posing, and has enough durability and the shooting and the ability to just kind of make it move in semi-realistic ways. Good for play as well. Of course, you can unite with any of the Toa or Umarak the Hunter, but they recommend that you unite this particular creature with Gali because of the color scheme, and also because, you know, the elements match and all. They have a kind of an action style of feature that allows the cannons to face forward, and it's activated from here. So by default, it's like this. It's not really useful in my opinion, when you have it just as a creature by itself, but it's nice to be able to bring that up once you do the unification, and you can still shoot. So it actually adds power, physical power, actual real life power to Golly, even just as an action figure, as a toy, because you can actually shoot now, in addition to still having full access to her normal weapon, and it doesn't really get in the way of her range of motion at all. You know, the creature itself is just on the back and really doesn't get in the way of anything except for the knob for the action feature of twisting at the waist. That does get blocked a little bit there. I recommend you might want to move the tail out of the way so you can still access this here. And yeah, I got the squeaky joint on this one, unfortunately. Sorry about that. Very annoying. Very, very annoying. That's the worst one that I've gotten by far. I've been pretty lucky with the others, but that is just the one thing that gets in the way. Otherwise, it's very complementary to Golly, and I think it has a similar amount of the high contrast orange color. So it helps, like you look at this from about this angle, and you just see the orange of Golly, and then you see the orange of the creature of Akida, and it just all feels very well united. So about that shadow trap, I made it clear before, I'm not a big fan of the shadow traps, just because I'm not a big fan of the shadow traps. I just don't like them in general. They're boring to me, period. Just the way it is, and nobody's going to change that. It's my opinion, and I have a right to that opinion, just like other people have a right to like them or even to love them completely. That's all good. I don't like them, but I do like this one relative to all the others. I like this one the best. It's so much bigger than all of the others. The legs are just so much longer. Plus they had little hands on the front, so you could use that, you know, put anything bar sized in there. You can use it to grab things, and it has a little propeller on the back. What? Propeller on the back. You can angle these outer leg pieces, which are great to get in this color as well. You can, you know, kind of bring it up like so, which looks kind of mean. You can bring them down. Look at that. I mean, it's just, there's so much personality. There's so much viciousness with just those angles there. I think that's pretty cool. And you can make it lean back, make it look like it's getting ready to strike. Like it really, you really have its attention now, you know, and you can also kind of go into a relatively boring look by just lining these up a little bit better, more the way that they intend for them to be lined up, where they're just kind of off to the side and just straight down. Doesn't have quite as much stability that way, so I personally recommend that you turn them out, you know, kind of turn them front and back a bit. But yeah, as shadow traps go, I think this one is quite good. So, end of the day, I like everything that you get here on the whole. I think that this is a better creature set to me personally, my personal opinion, than most of the others. Let me know what you think though. What is your personal opinion? Share your thoughts in a comment down below. Very much appreciated. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.